At their hiding point in the bush, they managed to take time to witness what was taking place.
On Saturday, the chief administrative officer for Buko District was shot at while traveling in his official vehicle, which was later set ablaze by the assailants. According to police, the incident that happened at Kidiowa Mabanda along Bombo Road was intentional, and the assailants could have trailed Ogwang from Buko all the way to Kampala.
His wallet, and also removed his phone. So upon checking the wallet, they noticed that he was the Mr. Ogwang whom they were looking for or targeting. So they fired several bullets at him from the passenger side and even set the vehicle on fire.
Police adds that a total of 4 suspects have so far been arrested to aid investigations into the murder. Among the suspects is Ogwang's driver.
This was not a robbery, or it was not an act of domestic terrorism. We believe it was a targeted murder, and so far we have 4 suspects who've been arrested, including the driver and another suspect who was arrested when our response teams from Gombe Police Post combed the area, and they got a gentleman who was hiding in the bushes.
Meanwhile, the police have warned business people against selling camouflage and military-like attires to members of the public. Police say criminals are using them to commit crime.
Therefore, we are going to take a tougher stance against persons who are found wearing or dealing in camouflage clothing in public.
And from the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, 2 people killed in the Chinawataka train accident have been identified.
This is called Aturinda Karorin, and the other one who died is called Nobert Tezikara. They allege he was the driver of that car at that time.
According to Nampima, the driver of the car was in the wrong. He must have stopped before proceeding to cross the railway line.
Listen and observe before crossing the rail line. But you see in the footage, they didn't observe any of these. They came, yet the train had also reached, and they joined the line at once. So their vehicle was hit in the middle before it crossed the rail line. So it's unfortunate that we lost these young people. But by law, you should not even put your vehicle on that rail line.
For Bombo Road accident that claimed 10 people, police say investigations are still on. The driver has been identified as 22-year-old Richard Seboa, who is currently hospitalized.
Giving you more updates on the same as we go on with the investigations. But as I stated earlier, the vehicle was speeding, had the rear tire burst, lost control, overturned several times.
According to the weekly traffic report, over 360 road accidents were registered in the previous week. 89 deaths were registered, while 266 people sustained serious injuries. Still from traffic, in the month of June, 1,825 road accidents were registered, 366 died, and over 1,140 people sustained serious injuries. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.